I'm an IFTM. I'm a guest faculty for IIT. So normally we used to, when we are having the Indo-African summit, after that actually we are building the capacity in Africa. So when you are talking to social ventures, we don't donate HADLs. We don't donate fish, but we teach how to cage fish so that is sustainable for the lifetime. So when you are talking to social venture, we believe in that. That is in our culture. So before, my friend has told Vasudeva Kutumbakam. I'll just extrapolate that. I will relate that more to business. So we have told a lot about the ecosystem. So when you are talking about the ecosystem, we are natural coexistence where we want to sustain that. That is very critical for all of us. But what is Vasudeva Kutumbakam? For our knowledge, it is 10,000 years back in the Rig Veda it was written. Before that, when it is written, we don't know. Kutumbakam means it is the family, which is the smallest possible sustainable human coexistence or a conglomerate. So when you are talking about family, human beings can exist with a family. And when you extrapolate that to in each and every context, let us start with economics. So economically also it is a viable system, viable possibility is family. So when you extrapolate that to the entire world, that is Vasudeva Kutumbakam. So when the world can coexistence, so how it will coexist? With sustainable development. So when you are talking of economics, when you are talking of any sort of development, so everything, now you are talking about WTO, etc., etc., that is not there. It was there 10,000 years back, or maybe we don't know what is the time. So when you are talking that sort of concept, then the social ventures are coming into picture. So in social ventures, when you a lot being told, I previously also, I'm just catching small points where it is viable for the entrepreneurs, and we have to think differently how it is possible. I'll just give an example of Kenya. We are talking a lot about plastic, and recently our Prime Minister also told about that. There is a gentleman, a Kenyan gentleman, he was actually featured in BBC, and he is among the top 50 richest persons in Kenya. Do you know what he was doing? He was just picking the eggs, and he was a college dropout. He could not study because he was not having money. So in order to continue his college, he started his venture by collecting the garbage, selling it in cages so that he can get some penny, and with that he studied. Then he started to realize, if I am selling it to somebody, so why not I will be doing that myself. So he went to Gonjao, he bought the first recycling plant, then he started on the recycling. Why I am saying so? It is a social venture where he started. He is conserving the society. At the same time, he is one of the richest person he could become, and till now, if you find him, he picks the garbage and he can sort the garbage in his own plant. That means, what he is doing, at any point of time when you go up the ladder, you should not be uprooted from the ground yet. So, when he started the garbage, because I used to meet him, so why you are doing that? Earlier when he started the plant, there was a lot of plastic seeds where the water pouches people are taking. So at that point of time, technically speaking, it was a polythene. Polythene recycling is different. Now actually they shifted to PET bottle. PET recycling is different. So when you are doing that, in PET you are making more money than PE. So all these sort of things, a lot of things, we have to put our idea, we have to go to the ground, and it is possible to get the money back. One more thing, just as while talking, in India we are talking about the ecotourism, where you go to Dharavi is the benchmark for all the filmmakers. I will be going beyond that. Have you been to Africa sometime? Or you must be watching National Geographic channel or maybe Discovery. In Animal Planet, wherever you go, you will find the picture of a Maasai. In the Maasai, when they go to the village, they are beautifully maintaining that. Only for what purpose? For tourism and business. And if you go to him, you want to give them the local currency, they deny it. They will be asking you, do you want it in dollar or euro? So when I went there, so I am a Tanzanian, I am coming into Tanzanian, so I will be giving you this link. No, my friend. Are you talking of euro or pound? We understand best. So that sort of opportunities are there. Whenever you are talking of social ventures, let us not confine ourselves to the small things. We have to think beyond that, we have to think differently. And just coming to that same, we are not knowing about it, we'll get foundation, blah blah blah. I'm an Indian. I was working in Tanzania at that point of time as a consultant. I was hired by Purdue University for Bill Gates Foundation to do a consultancy in Ethiopia. And it is a wonderful concept. and it is very much viable and possible for our Indian mindset. What is that? Ours is the agricultural land. So when you are talking of the farmer distress, we are all know that farmers are always getting suicide and we are getting the news for the wrong reason all the time. So how it is sustainable? What they were doing, farmers' biggest worry is their seeds. During the seeding time, they don't get the seeds. And even if they have to buy it, they have to buy it at higher rate. Because when the demand is there, supply is less, the price goes up. But what happens when he is harvesting? He is having a plenty of seeds. He is want to sell, but he cannot sell. Why? Because there is a lot of supply is more, demand is less. At that point of time, if he preserves some amount, small amount of his seed, then he can retain it properly so that during the seeding time he doesn't have to depend on anybody. That means socially we will be creating a solution for the entire ecosystem where it will be sustainable for him. And where the problem comes, how to preserve that. Because most of the people they are staying in a village, maybe in a thatched house. So how to preserve the seed up to 1 year? So that during the seeding time, the seed is not damaged for any reason. So how it will be sustainable? So I have to pack it in such a fashion so that it will be not getting moisture, rodents will not eat it, or some insects will not be coming. It will be very technical, elemental analysis do it. It will be very, very feasible solutions are there, but it is not reaching the ground. So what they wanted to do, they wanted to take a gunny bag. It is plenty in all the villages, or the jute bags or whatever bag you say. If you are putting it, it will not remain forever. Maybe for 1 month you can sustain it. So how to prolong the shelf life? Then what they thought? We will be putting a plastic seed inside it and we will not tie it, we will stitch it. How? So that the moisture will not pass through it. So for that they wanted to develop a technology. And how it will be reaching everywhere? Because if you are talking of value addition in a packaging, then nobody is going to give you 10 pouches because I will be not needing more. In a village, how many pouches you will be needing? Maybe 100 or maybe 500 at max. In a big village. So how to do that? So then the PhD will be making a system so that we will be purchasing it centrally and we will be not giving it for free but we will be selling it at low profit. That means we are talking about sustainable development. At the same time we are doing our social entrepreneurship and we are also making money. So that sort of thing we have to think innovatively. And why I PhD? Because I ventured all across Africa. Fortunately I have seen the developed world also, being a part of their ecosystem, being an Indian, my daughter studying in UK, I stayed in Africa, so I relate to the human race in a better way. So when you are talking of that, a lot of opportunities are there, but you have to think differently. We don't have to see, whenever you are looking at the greater picture, it looks very greenery. Greenery is always good, but at the same time, we have to do the macro analysis, and we have to see the, whenever going gets tough, the tough gets going. That is the same. So that is the exact same. Whenever we are talking of a lot of challenges, that means a lot of opportunities are there. How to grab it? It is upon us. So till last year, I was across the table. So now, when it is on this side, wonderful things are there. We have to take the right lesson, elemental analysis, and it is possible. Thank you.